Greetings. If you are a Muslim, I encourage you to watch so that you may learn the truth about what DDAP passed off on you. In part one, we excoriated, eviscerated, and emasculated the completely wrong teaching by DDAP that 8 male pronouns in one verse are unique and a secret symbol of Muhammad. Well, that only really introduces or begins the error train Mr. DDAP constantly drove off the tracks. Let's continue where we left off.
Man, not a ghost, not a spook. But we are told he's a spirit.
But we're told he's a spirit, DDAP muses. Before proceeding, who is DDAP talking about? Who is this he? In general, DDAP is talking about the Comforter, whom Jesus promised and was speaking about. John 14:26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit or Hagios Pneuma in the Greek, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. John 15:26. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me. John 16:13 you're familiar with. Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father has are mine, Jesus said. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine, and shall show it unto you. So DDAP is trying to spin his fabrication that the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, is really a mention of Muhammad. Remember that DDAP will say, Holy Ghost, as a way to confuse and separate the truth from your thinking. Remember, Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God, and Spirit clearly brings Holy Spirit to mind. But DDAP's trick is to make you think the Holy Spirit is a ghost, so you will not think of him with the word spirit. Let's watch DDAP sell his error.
But we are told he's a spirit. Is Muhammad a spirit? I say yes. That's what your Bible says.
But we're told he's a spirit. But is a word that indicates contradiction. For example, you said this, but I know the truth is something different. DDAP just claimed the Comforter is a man, not a ghost, not a spook. But the Bible says the Comforter is a spirit.
But we are told he's a spirit.
But we're told he's a spirit. Let's pause for a moment and just focus on DDAP's selective usage of words to support his deception. In his previous declaration, he used two synonyms of the word spirit, but not the word spirit itself.
Man, not a ghost, not a spook.
Man, not a ghost, not a spook. But the Bible says the Comforter is a spirit. His abuse of the text would be absolutely clear if he stated it this, the following way. A man, not a spirit. But the Bible says the Comforter is a spirit. DDAP could not sell his error, his fraud, if he stated it this way. A man, not a spirit. But the Bible says the Comforter is a spirit. So how can DDAP change the word spirit into another word? And how can DDAP change the word spirit that means Holy Spirit in the context of the Comforter into something else? DDAP wages jihad against the truth in two separate ways.
But we are told he's a spirit. Is Muhammad a spirit? I say yes. That's what your Bible says. You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost.
Here we see Didat wage jihad against the truth that in this context, the word spirit does mean the Holy Spirit. That's the truth. Every lie must have an element of truth in order to pass itself off as true. The word spirit does have multiple uses in Scripture. John 4:24, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. In this one verse, we see two uses of the word spirit, and neither means the Holy Spirit. So logically, it is possible that usage of the word spirit does not have to mean Holy Spirit. But when used with the word hagios, meaning holy, as in hagios pneuma, it is the Holy Spirit, the hagios pneuma. That is because words have meanings. The problem is that Didat and Islam in general do not know how to read logically and critically.
You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost.
You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it does not stand for the Holy Ghost. That statement is factually correct, but ignorantly misapplied. Every time the word spirit is used with the word hagios or holy, it does mean the Holy Spirit. There are four passages where Jesus mentions and teaches about the Comforter. Respect of the Injil that Prophet Jesus taught must include all four messages. The question for Muslims is if they have any respect for Prophet Jesus. John 14:26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit or Hagios Pneuma in the Greek. When Jesus introduces the Comforter, Jesus forever identifies the Comforter as the Holy Spirit with the words Hagios Pneuma. Subsequent usage does not need to include Hagios or Holy as a qualifier. So in John 14:26, Jesus establishes that the Comforter is the Holy Spirit, the Hagios Pneuma. Forever after, when Jesus says Comforter, we know he is speaking of the Holy Spirit. John 15:26, but when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of Truth. The Spirit of Truth is the Holy Spirit of Al-Haq. Remember, O Muslim, Al-Haq is another superlative name for Allah, who you think is God. So when Jesus, speaking of the Comforter, calls the Comforter the Spirit of Truth, that has significant meaning. Let's watch Didat's interesting diversion into delusion as he wages jihad against this wall of logic.
But we are told he's a spirit. Is Muhammad a spirit? I say yes. That's what your Bible says. You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost. Because in the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, we are told that seven spirits of God went out into the world. I say, you believe in seven Holy Ghosts? He says, no, there's only one Holy Ghost. I said, look, he says seven spirits. It means there should be seven Holy Ghosts. No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time.
Didat picks a fascinating gambit, the seven spirits of God. I have a whole video addressing this topic called Letter to a Muslim Brother 78a, The Seven Spirits of God. It is actually fascinating evidence that the Messiah is also God.
You see, every time the word spirit is used in your Bible, I'm telling the Christian, it doesn't stand for the Holy Ghost. Because in the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, we are told that seven spirits of God went out into the world. I said, you believe in seven Holy Ghosts? He says, no, there's only one Holy Ghost. I said, look, he says, seven spirits. Means should be seven Holy Ghosts. No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time.
Notice Didat continues to selectively employ the phrase Holy Ghost, never Holy Spirit.
No, spirit doesn't stand for Holy Ghost every time.
No, spirit does not stand for Holy Ghost every time. I am so tickled that Didat acts as if he has just proven Fermat's Last Theorem or Goldbach's Conjecture. But for his proof to have value, he must prove in this context, describing the Comforter, spirit does not mean Holy Spirit. But Jesus has already forever established that in the context of describing the Comforter, spirit does mean Holy Spirit. Now, if you are a Christian, you have the Comforter, the Holy Spirit within you, so you know this is true. But Didat thinks, bless his heart, that he has ripped the truth from your hands, and that spirit could mean anyone or anything. In the next video, we'll dissect how Didat attempts to change the Word of God from using the word spirit to inserting the word prophet. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.